and gentlemen, buon après-midi a tutte e a tous. Welcome to this performance about Dalcroze and contemporary. Of course, I'm very proud and happy to play Dalcroze piano music here in this context. And I started to know Dalcroze through his music, those three pieces and others which I am looking for were written before he started to compose the method. So those three pieces were published in 1902. So it's a little bit before the first edition of the method. And the other pieces of the program belongs to other composers contemporary at the same time of Emile Jaques-Dalcroze. If we can find a word to have an idea of this music, I think we can choose freedom, because it's music in the late Romantic style. Dalcroze studied in Austria with Bruckner, and it's evident the heritage of Bruckner music and all these long phrases which are never the same. Dalcroze very often, or let's say always, is changing something, polyphony, harmony, rhythmical pattern. So it's those three pieces are in a very free form, even if we can say that the simple form in music is ABA, so what the most simple we can have. But inside of this ABA, there are a lot of variation, a lot of changement, and a lot of color. The phrasing, it's very free. Sometimes it looks like an improvisation. So the first one is a ballade, and where we have a wonderful theme coming three times through the piece, but he will never present it at the same way. And then we have a capriccio, which is something like Brahms, but with much more freedom and a big power. And the last one is aria, with a very, very lyrical and intimate singing tone, with a lot of variation. I hope you will enjoy it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. The next composer is not strictly related with Dalcroze, but is the most important pianist and composer in Switzerland between end of the 19th and beginning of the 20th century. I'm speaking about Émile Robert Blanchet, who was a pianist, composer, concert pianist, and teacher at the Lausanne Conservatory of Music and director of the same school from 1905 to 1908. He was also a climber, so, and he wrote also some books. He was a quite interesting person. This piece, which I'm playing for you now, is the title in French is Tocsin. Tocsin means the bells of the church when you let go them to announce an exceptional event. The date that you have on the program, August the 3rd, 1914, is the declaration of the First World War. So it's quite unusual that a Swiss composer in a neutral Switzerland wrote a piece inspired to this date. What is interesting to say here is that this piece is a passacaglia. So there is a bass always the same, and Blanchet was a student of Ferruccio Busoni in Weimar and Berlin. And we can see, especially in this piece, but generally in his production, his idea of this symphonic piano. So it's completely different from Dalcroze. Sometimes some music by Blanchet is similar to Rachmaninoff for the big sound and powerful sound, but with a lot of color. You will see, we will start pianissimo and then there will be a big crescendo and I will play all over the keyboard, but always with the same theme, so with big chords, and then we will came at the beginning with a diminuendo. What's interesting to say is that Blanchet was quite obsessed by piano technique. He wrote a lot of studies, not for children, they are studies for advanced students, and he wrote also a book, The New Piano Technique, La Technique Moderne du Piano, this book will be published in 1935, and we are in the same area like the Principe Rationale de la Technique Pianistique by Alfred Cortot, which are published 7 years before. Blanchet is quite a big musician. His music is always powerful and maybe at the first listening quite difficult, but I hope you will enjoy. Émile Robert Blanchet, Tocsin.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. So the last composer in the program this afternoon is an American, George Templeton Strong, from New York. His father, George Senior, was the president of the New York Philharmonic in the 19th century. So George Junior came from a very cultivated milieu, and he was very, very fond of music. He would like to play an instrument, but he should have to follow the career of his father as a lawyer, so he didn't like so much. So first he went to Germany and then to Switzerland. And those four pieces, poems of 36, are handwritten. The legacy of Templeton Strong is at the Lausanne Public Library. And so this is something very, very particular. And Templeton Strong was attractive for the beauty of the landscape in Switzerland with mountains, lakes, and the nature. He was also a painter. And we have a very nice painting, amateur painting, but very, very high level. And we can see that there is a mixing between his music and his painting. Of course, those four small poems are like paintings. We have some poetry from the English literature. The third one is about Annabel Lee by Edgar Allan Poe. The fourth one, of course, Midsummer Night Dreams, Shakespeare. And the other two, the first is Morning from James Beat. And the second one is In the Forest by Bryant. So the great English or English speaking literature and the music is like a commentary. So it's again a very, very late romantic tradition. But what is interesting to say that the music by Templeton Strong sounds absolutely original, and you cannot put it like an imitation of nobody else, especially the first one. It's something between the jazzy and the Irish music, with this idea of the morning and the sheep and this very bucolic landscape. At the opposite, the second is very, very, very dark and very dramatic piece, very lyric. The third one, Annabel Lee, Elegy, and a little surprise for the last one. Ah, I forgot to say you that George Templeton Strong was very, a very good friend of Emile Jaques-Dalcroze. We have a letter from Dalcroze to Templeton Strong, where he's writing in a very, very simple but deep. We feel the deepness of the feeling between those two musicians. So just to put it in the context. Thank you very much. Just a few words. If you like this music, everything without the two Dalcroze, but we have a project for next time. Everything has been recorded, so you can have a look at the information desk and check if you would like to have some template on strong Dalcroze or Swiss music. Thank you again, everybody.